My name is Jessica, and I will be 26 tomorrow.
Okay, get in phase. Here we go.
I've always loved magazines. They get really expensive, so I tend to read them at the library or the bookstore. I love to window shop. I love just walking around stores. I love going up and down the aisles. Growing up, I had tics. When I was around 5, I noticed that my eyes would blink. A lot of sniffing, coughing, throat clearing, darting my eyes around. I just wanted to blend in. I didn't want to stand out. Good for me to have something to do with my hands, like a fidget cube or a stress ball. It's good for me to have tactile. I like the deep pressure from the weighted blanket. It gives me a calming effect, helps me sleep, helps me unwind. When I was younger, swinging was always something that I felt really calmed me. It was something I really enjoyed. It was relaxing. For people with Tourette's, when you're really deeply engrossed in an activity, it's almost like your tics go away. You're less likely to tic, and it's helpful to get yourself, you know, doing something you love. Some people call OCD the doubting disease. It might feel really uncomfortable for me to not, you know, seek reassurance and ask the same question over and over again and repeat myself and ask questions I know the answer to just to be absolutely sure, or check my pocket even though I know I put them there and I always put them there. Something makes me want to keep checking. The first time I heard about eating disorders, I was young and I read a book from the library. I thought that at least that will never happen to me. I remember thinking that at least an eating disorder is one thing that won't affect me because I just don't see it happening. Over time, I really started worrying about my weight, and I started worrying about my body image and food. It just became out of control. I was getting on the scale multiple times a day. I wasn't even believing the number. It just didn't seem real. I remember doing a lot of walking. I just felt like I had to get a lot of steps in, and it wasn't a certain number of steps, it was just a lot. And I don't know what a lot was, but I just felt like I couldn't eat until I got a certain amount of steps in. I had this fear of gaining weight. Purging was something I struggled with, vomiting, and it's a really dangerous behavior. It's shameful, it's secretive, it really makes you into a liar, lying to your friends and family about your intake, about your weight. It affects your appearance, it affects how you feel physically, and it really affects you emotionally. It goes against human nature. It's not what you're meant to do. It's not really living when 95% of your thoughts are just consumed with food. Something I've realized that's important is having a team of professionals that can help me and can work with me. Checking in with someone who just kind of reassures you that you're okay. I'm learning that I need to be kind to myself. I need to forgive myself, have compassion for myself, and it's okay if I slip up. You know, I can move on. A little lapse doesn't have to be a full-blown relapse. I know I can reach out to other people because secrets are what keep us sick. You need to talk to other people and let them know what you're going through. There have been times where I haven't been able to work due to my depression and anxiety. I find going to work gives me a purpose. I've made a lot of good connections at work with my coworkers. It's just nice to feel wanted. I've been very grateful that medication has helped me get to the point where I can work part-time. You know, tell myself I don't need the meds anymore and I don't want them. If I don't take it, then my quality of life goes down. I'm realizing how grateful I am that they exist. I like to smile at everyone. I like to make everyone feel good about themselves because I know what it's like to feel terrible about yourself, and I never want anyone else to feel that way.